Hello, all you beautiful people out there. I hope you have had or are having a fantastic day. If you're new around here, welcome. My name is Solomon the Teenager, who talks about teenage stuff because there simply isn't enough of it on the internet. God, it's been long since I've said that intro. It's good to be back. It's good to be back. Anyways, after last week's conundrum with the whole COVID-19 situation, we're back to the normal type of content with YouTube guides. And student guides is what I meant. Last week's video, I mentioned that we're gonna be talking about CAS, service in action this week. So that is the topic of today's video. So CAS, a lot of you tuning in might not even know what CAS really is, because either you're in the MYP, you're coming in from a different curriculum, or this is the first time you're hearing of something called CAS. So let's start at the very beginning. It's an IB core component. So there's a curriculum known as the IBDP. It's essentially what this channel is based on. And CAS is one of the components along with TOK and extended essay that make up your diploma program apart from your subjects. So this happens, this whole CAS project thing happens, or sorry, not CAS project, we'll get to that later. But this whole idea of CAS, it happens in year 12 and 13, so your final 2 years of high school. And there are a couple main bits within actual CAS. So you have CAS experiences, which we'll be explaining a lot later on in this video, and you have a CAS project. Look up on screen right now somewhere, there should be timestamps to where we talk over CAS experiences and a CAS project. So the basis of CAS, what it is, essentially it makes more well-rounded students come out the IB. It's a way to get students engaged in something other than their studies. So there are three main bits, hence the name CAS. So there's something called creativity, which is C, and that is a project or an experience. We'll be talking about all of this later, so don't worry if you're confused right now. There's a creative part of CAS, and essentially these are experiences or a project that focuses on design, learning an instrument, or advertising, something that showcases your creative side. Then there's a second part, which is activity, and this needs to be some form of physical activity, like a 30-day push-up challenge or improving performance in a sport XYZ by doing something. It's essentially like the viral stuff you guys see on YouTube if you're into the fitness industry and you see like, oh, impossible push-up challenge, pull-up challenge, body transformation, something like that. It doesn't need to be that, but those are just some ideas. It can be coaching, going to the gym, doing something physical. And then the last bit is service. So it's a community-based project. So the service experience or the service project, again, we'll be talking about experiences and projects later on in the video, is something in your community, something that helps out the community. And of course you can't be getting paid for it. It's like volunteering work, fundraisers, or environmental awareness, maybe doing like a beach cleanup or something like that. So those are the three main aspects of CAS out of the way. So those are the three bits and pieces that you need to do. We'll be talking about what you need to do in just a minute, but a couple more things that you guys need to know is that CAS aims to achieve 7 main outcomes, and those 7 outcomes are listed down below. We'll be moving on to those shortly, but essentially in that list of 7, you need to have a project, a creative project for one outcome, a creative project for the second outcome, a creative project for the third outcome. Don't worry, again, this may all seem confusing, but it'll become much clearer later on. And for each CAS experience, there's also a supervisor part. So to ensure credibility of your CAS work, you need a supervisor in order to make sure that you have an adult watching over you in case something might potentially happen to you, and also to confirm that you actually did do your project. Okay, that was a lot of information thrown at you all at once, but let's actually look at what you need to do in CAS. So if you do the IB, I'm fairly sure you have an online platform of some sorts. For most of the world, it's a platform called ManageBack, and it's very closely linked with the IB. This is where you'll find something called CAS. It's in your IB manager. If you press IB manager, you get chucked into a little thing called CAS. It's a little tab that's called CAS. And within CAS, there are a few things you need to do. So you have 2 things that you need to complete over the 2 years, the year 12 and 13. You have a CAS, you have CAS experiences, there are multiple, and you have 1 CAS project. Let's start by looking at CAS experiences. So what are CAS experiences? So they're short projects. That's hence the name experiences and not projects. So they're short projects. It needs to hit 1 or more of the CAS strands. And by strands, I mean these. So C, A, or S. You could have a cast experience that hits just one. You can have a cast experience that hits one or two. You could have a cast experience that hits all three. So that's what I mean when I say cast strands. And it needs to hit one or two objectives or outcomes. I should really change that to outcomes, max. So if we look down here, which we'll come onto later in more detail, these are the seven outcomes of CAST: strength and growth, challenge and skills, initiative and planning, commitment and perseverance, collaborative skills, global engagement, ethics of choices and actions. So for each of your experiences, you're gonna do two things. You're gonna pick, does my experience count as creativity, activity, service? Does it count as both? Does it count as all three? And then you also need to link that experience to one of those objectives. Guys, also don't worry, later on we have a whole guide as to how you can input these experiences into ManagerBack or into an online platform. So for now, all you need to know is that you need to come up with an experience. It needs to be either creative, a physical activity, or a service, and it needs to link to one of these seven objectives. Now let's look at some of the other requirements of a CAST experience. So over the 2 years, you need 16 experiences minimum. That's a lot of work over the 2 years. So you're gonna predominantly wanna focus on CAST during year 12 when you have some time on your hands, and not year 13 when you're literally getting exams thrown at you left, right, and center. You won't have time to focus on CAST in year 13. Trust me, get the bulk of it out of the way in year 12. Now, as we mentioned earlier, you must have a supervisor. This makes sure that you actually did the project, and they're gonna need to complete something called a supervisor review, which we'll also talk about a little later on in this video. And also a CAST experience, how do you determine if something is an experience? If you're doing it for about an hour or more, so say for example you had a one-off event where you did a presentation and that was it, that was your experience. So for example, one of my CAST experiences was a presentation about breast cancer for Pink Week, so that lasted about an hour. CAST experience done, check. Okay, now we're going to be moving on to your CAST portfolio and the importance of having a balanced CAST portfolio. So what a CAST portfolio is, sounds fancy, it's really not. It's the accumulation of all your projects and all your experiences and your one CAST project. Don't worry, we'll talk about it later. And it's important to have experiences for all three strands demonstrating all of these objectives. I have a little table at the very end of this video when we're gonna move on to the goodies, which makes that super clear, but essentially, what you need to do is, as we mentioned at the beginning of the video, you need to aim for a creative experience that links to each of these seven objectives. You can do that in however many CAST experiences you want, but in order to achieve balance in your CAST portfolio, you need to have a creative experience for strength, challenge, initiative. So that's seven experiences. For activity, that's another seven experiences. For service, that's another seven experiences. So 21 experiences in total, that's a lot. But here I said you need 16 experiences, and this is where linking projects come together. So you could have a creative and active experience at the same time, and it hits one or two of these objectives. So that marks off a lot already. That's four things that you need to hit, essentially, marked off in one. So without confusing you too much more, that's what I mean by having a balanced portfolio. Each of these strands needs to be hit at least once with each of these objectives. Okay, now you might be wondering, after I have my CAST experience chosen, how do I actually move on with it? Well, you need to have at least one reflection for each CAST experience. So this needs to be written, by the way, alongside an accompanying piece of evidence. So for a reflection, I'll show you guys how to write reflections and input reflections into ManagerBack later on in this video, so don't worry. But for now, all you need to know is that you need a minimum of one reflection for one experience. And in that reflection, you need to talk about, what did I do? How did I feel when I did it? And what did I learn? That's not, like, they don't ever tell you this, but this is what they want to see, and this is how I find it easier to write experiences. So feel free to take a screenshot of this small little mind map that you can refer to it when you're writing your CAST reflections. And also, for your evidence, of course, every CAST experience needs to have that one reflection, also needs to have evidence. How is your supervisor actually gonna see that you did it? You need to show them photos. You need to show them a picture of your actual project. You need to show them videos. Show them anything that proves that you did the project. Now we're gonna be moving on to completion of a CAS experience. So once you've chosen your experience, you've chosen the strand, you've chosen your objectives, you've done the write-up, which we'll talk about later on in this video. You've done your reflections, you've done something called CAS questions, which are also gonna be coming up a lot later in this video. I keep saying later in this video, but trust me, we're gonna get onto it soon. So once you've completed everything that you need, you're gonna complete a final step and you're gonna do a supervisor review. So on ManageBack, on your actual CAS experience, you can find a supervisor review form. With that form, you're gonna take it to your supervisor, they're gonna sign it, you're gonna scan it and upload it to that experience as either a reflection or under CAS documents, and done, that's it. Then your supervisor will tick, your CAS experience is done, and that's it. And don't worry guys, I have examples of a completed CAS portfolio, not a completed CAS portfolio, but a CAS portfolio in the project, so you guys can see what I mean when I say ticked and done. Now guys, I know that was a lot of information to consume at once, and let's actually visualize that information so it isn't as confusing. This right here is a screenshot of where you add a CAS experience. So right here, this is a picture of a ManageBack page. On the left right here, you have all your little pop-ups and your little sidebar. You have to go into IB Manager and there'll be a tab up here. I cut it out of my screenshot, but there'll be a tab up here that says CAS. Once you press that CAS button, there'll be a tab on the right-hand side that says press CAS, add a new CAS experience. That's how you come to this page right here. So let's talk about actually filling this in. So you have an idea for a CAS experience and you want to actually submit it onto ManageBack. This is how you do it. You press add new CAS experience and you start filling in this form. So if you're part of a group on ManageBack and you're doing your CAS experience as a part of a group, so say for example, it's the Duke of Edinburgh Award bronze level, you might have a ManageBack group for it. So here is where you can select that ManageBack group, but otherwise just ignore this little top section. This second section with the red star is what really matters. This is your experience name. So say for example, like me, you were doing a presentation for Pink Week. You write presentation for Pink Week, 2 years 10 and 11. I did it to years 10 and 11, for example. Or whatever your CAS experience is, you're gonna write it right there. Done, first part done. CAS project, we're gonna ignore that for now. We're gonna come back to that later. Activity type. So once you've chosen your experience, now you have to choose, is it creative, active, or is it a service? So based on the initial mind map that we did right here, are you showcasing your creativity? Does the project involve physical activity, or is it a community-based project? And then based off that, you can pick creativity, activity, or service. You do so by clicking each of these or whichever ones apply, and then you pick the number of hours you're gonna be doing it for. If your school is like mine, the hours may not matter as much because the IB have changes around how CAS works, especially for the graduating class of 2022 and later. So in your case, you might not need to focus on the hours that much, but it's always good practice to put in how many hours you're gonna be doing the project for. So say for example, that presentation that only lasted an hour and that was a service-based project and a creative-based project. So I put an hour for creativity and an hour for service. So this next part right here only really applies if you're doing a service-based project. It'll remain unhighlighted if you don't have service ticked, but essentially what it is that you need to pick the type of service. There are four types of service, and on ManageBack, if you hover on each of these, you'll get an explanation for what they are. But essentially, like, direct service is if you're actually going into the community and physically helping someone. Research is if you're conducting research to maybe raise awareness or make a website or something along those lines. For more information, please refer to your ManageBack tabs and you'll see all the information on there if you hover over the icons. Now, approaches. What is your CAS experience going to be like? Is it going to be an ongoing project? For example, maybe you're gonna be doing something related to fitness and of course you're gonna wanna have that ongoing. Is it gonna be something in your school? Is it gonna be something in your community? Maybe if it's service-based, or is it gonna be individual? Are you doing this on your own? Now, next little bit is your start date and your end date. So when are you starting your CAS project and when are you finishing it? Pretty self-explanatory. Put the start date, put the end date in, Easy as that. Now next we move on to your supervisor. So how do you pick your supervisor? A supervisor is someone who watched you complete the experience. So for example, in my case, my form teacher watched me complete the Pink Week presentation because it was through Zoom, I was in the classroom. So I put her as my supervisor. Who can be your supervisor? It can be a parent, a teacher, a coach. Who can't be your supervisor? It can't be a student or someone that's under 18. For the most part, someone's watched you complete your experience. So whoever that was, put them under this tab, their name, their title, their email, and of course their contact number. Now, once all those formalities are out the way, this is where we actually begin describing your project. So you'll be faced with this small little box that says project description and goals. This is where you have to write a couple things and they're included in red here. So what are you actually going to do? When are you going to do it? Where are you going to do it? What is your role going to be and who is going to be working with you? All of this needs to be in a small paragraph typed up right here, and all these questions need to be answered. And also, my personal tip is include something about your personal background, something that helps with authenticity. A lot of the times CAS projects are, well, faked and people don't really do them, but if you add some form of personal element as to why you want to be doing that experience in the first place, then it really helps making sure your project is authentic, personal, and meaningful. And then this last part right here is where you select your outcomes. So here you can see the 7 outcomes we talked about earlier. So say for example, that Pink Week presentation, it contributed to collaborative skills because I was working with other people. And it also, I think I picked initiative and planning. I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure I picked these 2, initiative planning and then collaborative skills, because I was working with other people and then we planned out the presentation and whatnot. So make sure your experience links to one of these objectives. You can pick a maximum of 2. Remember that, a maximum of 2 objectives per experience. And that's it. Once you've finished all of that, you'll click add CAS experience and that's done. Your supervisor will go through and they'll approve your project. An approved project looks something like this with a little thumbs up next to it. Now what's next? Once you actually start working on your experience, you're gonna need to be adding reflections to that experience. And that's where this reflection tab comes in. So as you can see, if you press on your CAS experience, you'll have a little tab on the right side that says add reflections and evidence. It'll bring you to this page. So you can add a journal entry, a written reflection. Remember, you need to have at least 1 written reflection per experience, then tick the outcome that it applies to. Of course, when you're adding your evidence, you can add a website, a video, a photo, a file, whatever it may be to prove that you've done that project. So this is pretty self-explanatory. Add those reflections in and remember, when you're doing your reflections, answer. What did I do? How did I feel? What did I learn? And also, alongside your reflections for each experience, you're gonna need to complete a set of CAS questions. These CAS questions are automatically generated by ManageBack depending on the outcomes that you've chosen. So you're gonna need to answer every single one of these questions for each of the experiences. Usually they're pretty straightforward and they're not that difficult to answer. Now this is an example of a CAS portfolio. Currently I have 3 experiences and then 1 project right here. You can see here the Pink Week presentation for years 10 and 11. If we go through here, it was creative service. This is a checkmark that has been reviewed by my supervisor and it was school-based and it was advocacy for the type of service. Then of course, 2 reflections, 2 hours, as I mentioned earlier. And this is just a collection of all your CAS experiences and your CAS project. Then you've got how many times you've hit each outcome with what projects. So throughout this video, I've mentioned a CAS project quite a bit. Now, what is a CAS project? If we go right here to your proposal sheet, which is right here, you can actually have the option to take a CAS project. Now you only need to do 1 CAS project throughout the 2 years. And a CAS project is just like an experience, but it needs to be at least a month long. So it's a very, very long CAS experience and it needs to be a bigger project. It can't just last 1 hour. It needs to last a lot longer than that. And it needs to have some element of collaboration. You need to have multiple reflections. And of course, to select a CAS project in your portfolio, you're gonna need to, or sorry, not in your portfolio, in your event proposal, you're gonna need to literally tick CAS project. Now remember, only 1 CAS project over the 2 years. So you don't have to do many of these at all and they need to be a month long. Really, that's key. And of course they need to be collaborative. Now guys, that is really it. That is a full breakdown of CAS. I hope I didn't overwhelm you guys with too much information. Of course, if you do have any questions, please leave them down in the comments below. And before we end the screencast, we're gonna look at some useful goodies. Now, here is a table that demonstrates what I was saying earlier about hitting every objective with every strand. As you can see, guys, the outcomes are listed here on the side and each of the cast aspects are listed across right here. Every time you complete a new cast experience, you guys can take a screenshot of this and tick them off. So say, for example, like me for the Pink Week presentation, it was plan and initiate activity. So that was creativity hit, that was service hit, in that one outcome. So guys, feel free to take a screenshot of this little table so you guys can use it when you're completing your own cast experience. Now guys, there are actually a couple things that you can't do for a cast experience. If you are being paid for your cast experience, you can do it. If you're fulfilling religious obligations, you cannot do it. Fulfilling family obligations, you cannot do it. And if you're required to complete it as a part of your academic course, you cannot do it for cast. Cast needs to be initiated and planned by you guys. It is not a part of your school academic courses. It needs to be a you sort of thing. And of course, the last little bit right here is a checklist. So this is a qualitative checklist and this is a quantitative checklist. If you guys are ever looking through your cast portfolio, make sure that it hits every single one of these points. Again, you can take a screenshot of this and refer to it whenever you're working on your cast. Now, I did steal these last little three pieces from our school's cast frequently asked questions document. So massive shout out to them for putting it together. It's really helpful and I hope it'll benefit you guys out there as well. Holy crap, I've talked for a good 40 minutes now just blasting you guys with information, and let's say I'm kind of sweating my ass off because it's skin against this pleather, let's put it that way. So anyway guys, I hope you did enjoy it. I hope I provided you with some valuable information. As always, if you do have any questions about cast, leave them down in the comments below. I'll be more than happy to answer them. And if I did miss anything out, also let me know in the comments down below. I'll make sure to put in a comment, pin the comment, so you guys have all the information you need. As always, if you guys did enjoy, I'd be super appreciative if you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. We're growing like crazy these past 2 weeks. We've gained like 10 new subscribers. Sorry, not past 2 weeks. What am I saying? This past week, we've gained like 10 new subscribers. Every time I check my studio app, we have like one or two new subscribers, and that's absolutely amazing, guys. I can't thank you enough for the support. And anyways, stay safe, stay sane, don't stress yourself out too much, and I'll see all of you guys later.